With every meal, we take up nutrients from the soil. But as we take up more nutrients than we bring back through sanitation, the soil loses fertility. Soil depletion in Tanzania is worsening, and the resulting meager harvests lead to food insecurity. At the same time, most rural farmers cannot afford artificial fertilizers and lack a sufficient sanitation system. The traditional pit latrines they use bear a health risk.
We are trying to avoid the mixture of urine and feces together going down to the earth, contaminated with maybe groundwater, where the groundwater is contaminated with these bacteria and whatever. Now, a human being, when he takes water from the ground, they are not safe. So that's why we find that there is a lot of diarrhoea disease or waterborne disease.
The uncontrolled overflow of nutrients into the water cycle also leads to fish kill. But flush toilets are no alternative in these rural communities, as water is scarce in many regions of the country. Local organizations in Tanzania, therefore, develop ecological sanitation systems which aim to combine health promotion, environmental protection, and the recycling of nutrients. The main principle is to use so-called UDD toilets, urine-diverting dry toilets, which collect urine and feces in separate containers to then recycle this organic matter and bring it back to the fields as a fertilizer.
We designed those eco-sanitation latrines, and then we train the community to not use them. Those are made up of cement, so they become affordable to most of the communities. And we usually train the farmers on how they can use those remains as fertilizers. We got from other areas, one of our staff who went to South Africa and get some how this technology can be constructed. So after getting that technology, we redesigned that team.
A research collaboration called CASA between Engineers Without Borders Berlin and the organization Mavuno in Karagwe researches on combining sanitation and the carbonization of soil to produce a highly fertile black soil called Terra Preta. After separation of urine and feces, the naturally almost sterile urine is stored for up to 3 months, whereby all bacteria is killed. Feces, however, can contain a lot of pathogens. Therefore, they are heated for around 3 hours at a temperature of 75 degrees and then are stored in a compost. This Terra Preta compost consists of a mixture of soil, charcoal, wood chips, pieces of bricks, and microbes. The mixture turns into a dark and clean soil within 3 months.
We are doing different feed trial comparing the different fertilizer. So we have done 3 feed trial using biogas straw, this compost from human excretes, cow dung. We are testing how they increase maybe production.
The crops grown on the Terra Preta compost are visibly much bigger and look healthier. But some laboratory tests are still pending.
We need first to do laboratory testing, especially nutritional testing, for the crops grown out of this fertilizer from CASA compost. We need also to check the soil analysis before and after using this kind of compost. What also we are trying to see is the quality of the compost that we are preparing.
The potential of Terra Preta to improve soil fertility in the long term is a hotly debated topic in the research and academic community. When it comes to sanitation, however, science may not neglect people's intimate needs.
In our customs, if you ask someone to collect his own dung, then that becomes a little bit of, they wouldn't take it lightly. So the culture also has to be studied.
Systems coupling sanitation and composting, as currently developed here in Tanzania, might provide a solution for the global challenge of closing the natural cycle of nutrients.